Hey gang, good Tuesday morning, afternoon, wherever you are. It looks like the Biden administration is gonna get hard on gun control and our gun laws. Let's have a listen.
Biden's pushing Congress to buckle down on gun control. On the third anniversary of the Parkland, Florida mass shooting, Biden called for stricter oversight for gun owners and manufacturers. NTD's Melina Weisskopf tells us what Biden says his goals are and what they could look like in practice. Biden's now calling for a few sweeping gun control measures. He's asking Congress to start working on laws to take away immunity for gun manufacturers. Immunity is what protects gun manufacturers from being sued for any violence that may happen with their product. If this immunity is stripped away, the manufacturers themselves are at risk of being stripped away too.
First of all, he's trying to make sure that gun manufacturers can be sued for the misuse of their firearms, so that if a criminal committed a crime with a gun, the manufacturer could be sued for the damages, which would put every gun manufacturer in America out of business.
Biden also wants Congress to pass a law banning assault weapons and high-capacity magazines. This, of course, is an attempt to prevent violent crime, but cities that have implemented stricter gun control laws are cities that continue to see high crime rates, like New York, Chicago, and Los Angeles. Another law Biden's advocating for would require background checks on all gun buyers. The vice president of the Second Amendment Foundation says it could be a step toward a government-held list of gun owners. In places like the 1930s in Germany, those were used to confiscate civilians' weapons and impose a total ban on guns.
But it happens in any totalitarian type country, and once totalitarian leaders pop up pushing socialism and other, government schemes controlling the populace, one of the things their means to make sure they can implement their philosophy is to ban firearms.
And Congress already has some legislation that goes even further than Biden's proposals. Representative Sheila Jackson Lee from Texas wrote legislation that would require gun owners to pay at least $800 a month for an insurance policy.
Wow. Oh, yeah, wow.
Gutland says lately they've seen skyrocketing support for their grassroots efforts to protect the Second Amendment.
Gun owners are responding. They're now realizing that their rights really are under attack and under threat.
Now, even though Democrats control both the House and the Senate, some Republican senators would need to support these efforts to pass new gun laws. Melina Weisskopf, NTD News.
Wow. So, gang, I guess we'll see if Biden's administration will be the first administration to, take our Second Amendment rights away. How about that? Have a great Tuesday. God bless.